pirating is in my blood, like adrenaline or stale grog.
Hi everyone, welcome back to RPS and PAX, and today I'm joined with the one, the only Ron Gilbert, and we're going to talk about Return to Monkey Island. So yeah, Ron, what can you tell us about the story, the characters, like, what is it like for you to be returning to, like, this world?
It's been a lot of fun. I mean, it's been a lot of 30 years since I really immersed myself in that world, and it's a lot of fun to, like, get back to it, you know, and I was a little worried at the beginning what that was going to be like, kind of get my head around that, but it is just kind of like a comfortable glove at some point. We started working with Dave, and we just kind of fell into it so quickly.
Wow, really? That sounds awesome. Yeah. Can you tell us a bit about what the story will be about?
Well, the story is, we kind of call it, it's unfinished business. You know, Guybrush, the first game was called The Secret of Monkey Island, but he never really found The Secret of Monkey Island. Mm. And so it really is about him wanting to actually find the real secret to Monkey Island. And I think it's also unfinished business for us, for Dave and me as designers, because, you know, we never disclosed what the secret was. And the end of Monkey Island 2 is this bizarre cliffhanger. And it's like, so for us, it's unfinished business. And for Guybrush, it's unfinished business.
Yeah, we were kind of talking about this kind of cliffhanger at the end of 2. Mm-hmm. So, you know, this new game, where in the Monkey Island timeline will this land?
Well, the game starts right after Monkey Island 2 ends.
Oh.
And then it just gets bizarre from there. So...
Can you kind of explain what kind of, like, bizarre things that we're going
to... No, you have to buy the game.
I love that. So one thing on the panel was this idea about, like, puzzle creation, mm-hmm. and adventure games are kind of known for their challenging puzzles. Challenging. Will Return to Monkey Island kind of follow in its predecessor's footsteps, or what kind of puzzles are we going to see? What can we expect?
Well, it's definitely a point-and-click game. Right, mm-hmm. And there's a type of puzzle which really inhabits a point-and-click adventure. And so we are definitely doing that. I think, you know, times have changed, players have changed, we're mm-hmm. different people, we've changed. And I think adventure games need to change with that. And it's not about making things simpler, but I think it's just kind of how you design puzzles. You know, you need to be a little bit clearer about things with people. And you have a lot of people who don't know Monkey Island, don't know point-and-click games. You need to kind of ease people into that kind of stuff. And, you know, we've added one of the things we added to the game is a hint book that you can get.
Oh.
So if you are stuck, you can look at the hint book. And if you are stuck, I mean, these days when you get stuck on a puzzle, you don't puzzle through it for a month and talk to your friends. You just go to Google and you type it in. And so it's like, we don't want people to do that. It's like, we don't want people to leave our game to go look up a hint. Mm. So we've done a hint book in the game. It's part of the fantasy of the game. It's actually a physical object that Guybrush has in his inventory.
Oh, cool.
And you have to go get the hint book. You know, it's not something that's given to you. And so we hope that, you know, people do want hints. That they're going to use our hint system, because we're very clever about the hints.
Mm.
You know, we know where you are in the game. We know what things you've tried. We know all this information, so we can really give you hints that are very tailored to your kind of specific issue that you have.
Yeah, I know. I'll definitely be using that hint book throughout the playing the game, because, some of those puzzles I'll never forget. But that's really interesting how, like, you know, as someone who... has had a relationship with Monkey Island for so long. Like, how has your approach changed from the older games and now to the newer ones? Like, what's different?
I think creatively, kind of design story-wise, not much has changed at all.
Yeah.
You know, it's like you really kind of approach it the same way. And we, you know, we start by this kind of high concept for the thing, and we go down, and then it's like, you know, the individual parts of the game, and then below that, you know, the character arcs, and below that, the puzzles. And we've always done that with games, and I don't think any of that has really changed.
Awesome. Well, so I have one final request of you.
Mm-hmm.
Could you let us know your favorite and best pirate joke, if you have one on hand?
Don't ask me jokes. I am, you know, I like writing comedy, and I do that, but I'm just horrible at jokes, because I never remember them.
I'm exactly the same. Yeah, so I'll tell
I
you just, what.
I don't have any.
I'll do my best pirate impression then, okay, if you do one.
No.
Just me then.
The other thing I hate is doing an impression.
I won't put you through that. It'll just be me then. I'll do my lone. Arr! All right. But Ron, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with us. Everyone at RPS on the team and our supporters are really excited to return to Monkey Island. But thank you so much.
Excited to have you return.